I have something rather special to show you. This is a standard transistor tape recorder made by the Standard Radio Corporation of Japan. It looks like a cassette recorder, doesn't it? It's from the 1960s, which you can tell by the type of box they used. They still were using the strings that wrap it all together. What is it? Is it a tape recorder? Is it a cassette recorder? What is it? Let's take a look inside. So you open the box. I got this from eBay. It doesn't have the styrofoam packing material, but here is the tape recorder that we see on the box. What is it? Is it a cassette recorder? Well, it certainly could hold a cassette. I'm not going to tell you what it is.
Hold it, hold it. Stop the credits. We can't do this. Our fans need to know what this machine is.
All right, I'll stop teasing you about this machine. Even though it looks like it could be a cassette recorder because a cassette fits here, it's actually not. It is a tiny reel-to-reel tape recorder. It takes these little 2-inch reels, which are smaller than the reels used by the Concord F-20 or the F-85 or the National Snap. It is capstan drive. The capstan is located underneath the non-removable head cover. There is a single combination record, playback, and erase head, and it runs at 1 7/8 inches per second. The lid does not come off, it's simply hinged. There is a rewind button, a stop button, a play button, and a record button. For level, there is a light that flashes inside this red bezel, and there is a volume control. The front of the machine has input for a 9-volt DC external supply, earphone output, and remote microphone input. The back of the machine has a sliding door for 6 AA batteries, creating a 9-volt system. This is the microphone that came with the unit. It's unique in that instead of a sliding on-off button, it's a push on-off button. We simply plug the microphone into the front of the unit, set the volume control, press record and play at the same time. Testing the standard SR200 reel-to-reel capstan drive tape recorder with the cute little 2-inch reels. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's all there is to it. Rewind. Playback.
Testing the standard SR200 reel-to-reel capstan drive tape recorder with the cute little 2-inch reels. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.
Now you can hear it's a rather staticky sound. This is a DC bias machine. It has a fairly low quality amplifier. You can improve the sound a little bit by plugging in an external speaker. In this case, I have the Wall & Sack speaker from the 5750 machine that I own, and you can see a video about the 5750 by looking in clydesight's videos. So, rewind.
Standard. Testing the standard SR200 reel-to-reel capstan drive tape recorder with the cute little 2-inch reels. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4.
The standard SR200 is actually a very well-designed machine, similar in many ways to the approachability that I found in the Lloyd's 8V84A, which you can see by looking in clydesight's videos for embracing your inner cassette recorder. The back of the machine is held together by a single screw, so you can lift the whole bottom cover off. It's very simple. Here is the amplifier board, here is the battery compartment, and here is the motor with a little tiny capstan flywheel. And the belt that drives the flywheel from the motor is unique in that it is clear rather than black. The capstan has a double bearing system. There's a bearing underneath this cup here that holds the grease, and of course there's a bearing on the top part of the machine. To take a look at the top part of the machine is again very simple. remove three screws and flip it over and lift the whole top off. Now here we see the drive mechanism, which again is quite fascinating. The capstan flywheel, which we saw here, has a pulley, which you may be able to see on the side. There's a pulley here, and that drives this belt located here, which is wrapped around an idler and, of course, the usual friction clutch mechanism for the take-up reel. When put in rewind, this idler moves against the feed reel drum, and that's how you have the rewind function. You can see that the capstan is spinning, and because of the clutch mechanism, this is now free because the clutch has been lowered, and the rewind is taking place on the feed reel table. And you see how this moved out of the way now to put the friction back with that. For play, it just simply drives the whole system. This is the pinch roller, this is the capstan, this is the combination record, play, erase head. That's it. We're going to try and make a recording from the radio with the standard SR200. The amplifier is not very good, so the quality is not going to be that great, but let's try it anyway. And then turn on the radio.
So she took her love for two cares a while upon the fields of barley. In his arms she fell as her hair came down among the fields of corn. Will you stay with me? Will you be my love among the fields of barley? We'll forget the sun in his jealous sky as we lie in fields of
the machine has the constancy of capstan drive, but the amplifier is so staticky with the DC bias that unfortunately all the quality of the drive, which they put a lot of time and effort in, is kind of hampered by the rather crummy amplifier. While it's a standard SR200, it's not really setting any standards. Thank you for watching the video.